Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another exciting, another wondrous Propagandacast. With me, your host, Imperial Dane. We are off here to an exciting one, Mrs. One, on Langraskaya. Winter, we shall be watching RNG Weve fighting for the glorious Soviet Union, the 31st Rifle Corps dispatched here to make a penetration to the German lines, being held up currently here by Spanky and the 101st Jäger Division. With some Pioneer up here. Infantry company all top, and we're noting here guard motor, shock rifle, and partisan tactics are his commanders available to support Weve in his offensive motions, where Spanky has Jäger armor, Jäger infantry, and close air support, a bit of a mix there in commanders. Two of them, though, pretty heavily dependent on munitions. So there's definitely something going on there. Certainly rare to see Jäger armor nowadays, but there you go. Engineers and conscripts moving out here. It looks like he's ignoring the initial victory point rather than interesting note. But the 101st Jäger Infantry Division holding the line here for the Reich near a collection of collective farms until panzers can arrive and lead a counterattack. But conscripts here moving out. Points are being secured. Rushing here straight for the mission fuel again. Is this actually intentional? It rather seems like he's then actually ignoring the fuel even then. It seems to be playing something even more aggressively. Rather interesting to note. Looks like at least he had a change of mind. But munitions then, it's emphasis there. From Weve, pioneers have engaged. We are seeing here a rather emphasis on the right hand side here from Spanky. Rather heavy emphasis there, and not even securing the point there. That is definitely some rather bold play by both players. In fact, both sides are, to a certain extent, going for some rather extended connecting in points. Spanky in particular, but at the same time, so is Weve. And I'm really deeply surprised with this viewpoint basically being ignored. Notice here they're engaging the conscripts, holding up positions here. Points being rapidly secured for the Fatherland. Pioneer moving out. Another great squad here to sort of hold up the right flank as conscripts launching in there. There we go, quick Molotov, lights of snow and fire. Gonna just trying to get back into the house. Someone holding the door ever nicely. And we're seeing an additional grenade squad here, so pretty heavy infantry start here from Spanky so far. We are looking at four Grenadier units here fighting versus the Russians, who's also got four conscript squads out so far, to a certain extent mirroring each other. Though so far Spanky does have the fuel advantage, but again, rather tenuous amount of territory here, whereas we are seeing that Weve actually holds more territory overall. Heinrich catches on fire there, rather unfortunately. Conscript going down there in the snow, the deep, deep snow. Conscript moving from the other side, more Molotovs there. Grenadiers are fighting versus combat engineers, troops making their way back. Grenadiers forced to vacate the premises, rushing to get there for the fuel point, while the Germans are occupied here in the snow. More conscripts moving in, this would rather turn ugly for the Grenadiers, taking up position in the bushes. Two Grenadier force here fighting each around one of the important points, but at the same time cutting off here. This is not looking good, I mean a bit of a regular. And they've got Molotovs taking all these wounded Grenadiers. Heavy losses and damage there to Spanky, forcing off the field. He might in fact lose risking an entire Grenadier squad if not careful, but looks like they just barely make it in the meanwhile over here. The conscripts are having an alright fight versus the Grenadiers. Them in heavy cover, the Grenadiers light cover, this so it's thus holding a bit of advantage and slowly bleeding out the Grenadier there. Territory overall collapsing here for Spanky. MG42 arriving, we're noting here a bit of taking up a support weapon company here for Weve. Fuel point finally being secured there as well for Weve. Bit late though, but again now in fact soon holding both fuel points. Bit of a setback there for Spanky. So far nice pressure here from Weve, rather aggressive pushing across as many points as possible. But now encountering the MG42, the Schwerz engage line feels like immediately on the conscripts. They do manage to make it up behind an old truck just in time. Bullets flying through the air and impacting mostly upon the truck. And it is refreshed, sort of, and moving out, and at least replenished. Conscripts continue to hold out, although they yet to actually inflict further losses upon the German infantry. In fact, they might want to consider retreating soon. MG42 up to deal with the other flank. And there we go, I mean, we're seeing here Weve actually launching a rather nice assault here on the MG42, attacking from several angles. And there we go, forcing Spanky off the field once more. More conscripts moving up, taking up the post here from the other squad, allowing them to fall back. Constantly tying up, looks like here Spanky's had enough. Four Vietsmen there. Sestuyan Sisiwosen, and getting out there trying a bit more of a cohesive and focused effort, although he might want to actually, and this is actually a bit surprising, that he's not actually moving to the squad over here to sort of try and flank them out, having one squad occupy them here, then have another squad flying at them from the side. A bit unfortunate. MG42 there to support the Pioneer, a few point munitions being secured, cutting off there, leads to deny. Weve a bit of fuel, but Weve is gaining a ton of fuel compared to Spanky at the moment. Pioneers are getting shot at by the counter grenade, going before firing away, and rifle grenade here, so he has teched up. Doing a nice job there, there's a counter grenade effect denying some of the cover to them. Good job there. Still, the situation is looking a bit grim here. And we're seeing an immediate move on, checking up really rapidly here for Weve, taking advantage of his great map control so far. The fact he's pushed back Spanky for most point to help both fuel points, in fact. Really outstanding aggressive play there from Weve. Outstanding. Let's quickly take up position there. They have to be careful about some Molotovs.
On our
there go, quick Molotov. Also, one odd feature about this house, you can enter it through here, but you can't exit it for some reason. It's a bit of an odd building in that regard. Shit. Rushing straight for the fuel point, Spanky knows what's up, and it's nothing good.
At
least he has an idea of it. So far, no sign of a likely mechanized company. He's desperately trying to get some territory back and deny fuel. Built. And of course, Weve is just working with that tank of the battalion command. He's got tons of munitions as well. He could easily lay down a bunch of mines if he so wanted. Van is in a rather poor position versus the conscripts. Forced to fall back. No commander so far from Weve. Field hospital up there. Half check available. That's the first unit, but could be zooming up for T-70. Rough gonna hit. Oh, failed to make an impact upon the Russians. Spanky is definitely overextending him right now. I mean, he's getting a bit desperate here to sort of do something against his opponent. And there we go. We're actually seeing a half tank on the way. And with that amount of munitions, could be, in fact, aiming for the court mount. That could actually be rather dangerous now to Spanky, since, well, he's barely got anything else. He's certainly got nothing that could sort of reliably deal with it from a safe distance. And soon the M5 half tank is out. Combat units moving forward. Him before 2 needs to set up.
Half track has been assigned to our forces.
And there we go, half track arriving. And there go, court mount on the way.
Taking MG fire.
Rolling forwards here. And there go, front mounted 50 caliber opening up there. MG crew going to have to pull back.
This is our sector now.
Rather unfortunate situation here. And it is in a bit of trouble. And there we go. Quart mount unleashes quart mounted death, mowing down the crowds. Spang here just getting utterly thrown back. Utter chaos and anarchy. Really vicious play there by Weve. So I need to take advantage of the team. We are seeing like the guys company going up. And they're close to getting wiped out on retreat. And oh, he's just shredding the Pioneers, it's just a massacre, but there we go. Do see that Spanky manages the Panzerfaust here. Weve was perhaps a bit too eager, a bit too reckless. I mean, he didn't wipe out the Pioneers while delaying the mechanized company, but at the same time, his half takes on the fight, at the same time, it is Veterans 1. And there we go, rifle grenade going off. Oh, and he gets it well played there by Spanky, absolutely astoundingly well played there. Good improvisation there, rifle grenade knocks out the last bit there. Crew sent flying out onto the cold and snowy roads of Langreskaya. And we actually now need to getting a mortar, a granatenwerfer.
Be brave, comrades!
But this is dangerous, definitely dangerous. We're seeing actually a second half tick on the way. He's still got munitions for another quart mount, so could be. He's acting up for that. We're seeing fresh pioneers arrive to probably, hopefully, finish that mechanized company. Constantly getting caught out in the middle of them by a large force of grenadiers. Light trying to get off a mortar there and knock out the MG, but at the same time, he might lose the constant quarter here. He might lose it. He might again. Gun a bit over eager here, and that seems to be a bit the case here. Weve is getting rather confident and might be making more risks than is actually necessary. I mean, that can happen. That can happen. Oh, grenades are just burning up, though. I mean, we are still seeing here Spanky's taking some massive losses. Mortar is appalling the straight MG 42 firing away. There we go, second port mount on the way. A mortar also arriving here for Weve, but again, we're noting he's still also a bit bled up. He's also noting he's got plenty of manpower for something more. Mortar here surprised by a squad of conscripts. We go like to make a nice company is up.
Shooting at us!
The enemy has 300 points remaining.
There you go, engineers trying to make a run there for the building, getting some press to the right in front of everything. Not having a fun time there. Cut's coming from the other flank, and he's moving forwards. Definitely a lot of trouble here. There you go, the Courtman just unleashes volumes of death from the 450 cal machine guns. Later, the Americans did make a slightly bigger.
Standing by!
Well, use bigger guns for anti-aircraft mounts there on their half tracks, I believe. Then it's continuing to burst into flames here versus the conscripts, molotovs, the fangibles of doom. No sign of a oh, he might lose another conscript here though. Ow! Two conscript squad losses here. Weve does need to be careful, he does need to be careful. I mean, he certainly has reason to feel confident, but you know, a few unfortunate casualties here and you can end up, you know, losing a lot. And the enemy just lost two conscript squads in short. So I'm also here, Jaeger infantry, but at the same time, Spanky's not yet able to utilize it due to this insane pressure being laid down upon him by Weve. Could we see a pack out now? A Panzerbekanone? Yes, indeed. Jaeger infantry receiving the Panzerbekanone he needs. Courtman here, they're just pouring bullets into the wooden facade. The wooden walls providing scant refuge there for the Grenadiers. Mortarans doing what they can. And we are noting here a field gun arriving here for Weber. He could consider getting a maximum to help deal with some of the infantry. The Grenadier squad needs to get out of there. The building is not safe anymore. The building is not safe.
Requested units have
we're just seeing here that Weber just keeps pushing on mercilessly. Pants up there, Canona moves up there, gun is caught on fire. Courtman there, exposing itself. Ah, Weve, you might have gotten a bit too cocky there. Gun needs to fall back. So, Wix of Fun, alternating here, rather a bit of marshal floated. Mortarans there doing nice work, MP as well. Can he catch that half tank? I mean, he got a bit lucky there with heavy engine damage. He's showing it won't be moving very far, which might actually give his pack a chance to catch up if he can clear out the conscripts there, blocking his way. You see the field gun actually zing up then, firing away a light barrage, shattering the fence a bit. And at the same time, a small plucky pioneer squad there, harassing the far western field point. There we go. Conscripts forced away, allowing the pack to move in. Can he catch up there? Can he catch up? They're taking up inside that ruined house, finding a way there. Comrades need to fall back as well. Pressure all over the place, and there we go. Pants up the Canona, blast apart the second half track that Weve summoned out. Both the Mangs do quite a bit of damage though to Spanky. Though the first one really had the most shock impact, the second one less so. Internet, there's been no sign of mines here from Weve to sort of perhaps, you know, further solidify his hold to make it much harder for Spanky to get back in the fight. Rather unfortunate.
Sector is ours.
Once more, Spanky marches forwards for the Fatherland, noting he's teched up. Not sure what that field gun is up to. But running into some problems with some rather tenacious grenadiers. And there we go, another barrage. Shooting open a nice chunk of the building. Shock troopers have arrived, so Weve has gone for, I believe, shock rifle. What's the one he had an act off of that? And that's definitely going to cause a bit of a problem here for Spanky, though. The two shock trooper squads, or the shock trooper squad, are found there. MG here could switch out and turn it on being round. Still no real upgrade here, and we're noting a support armor core is up. There's still some time off before being able to get anything from it. Rather tense fighting here, guys need to fall back. So we can Mortars here trying to catch the shock tubers and bury them deep in the heart ground. Looks like shock tubers might get the grenadiers. No, no, looks like just barely making it, just barely. MG though, once more Spanky's false support back. I mean, really just keeps up the damn pressure. And then go T-Fed. Oh, KD-8 flamethrower tank has been summoned in on the field. Ooh, that could prove just to be what is needed. I mean, Spanky's got very little to hold back. A KD-8, he's got one pack. And a KD-8 can essentially drive straight up to it and clear it out. It's rather dangerous. I'm missing a second mortar. Viva just really going into siege mode to a certain extent. Just adding in a small mortar battery there. I mean, bold, bold. The only thing that might be holding back is again those severe infantry losses you suffer. But there you go. KV-8 charging forward. Back firing. Can he get off a Panzerfaust to sort of damage his engine? There we go. Small amount of fortune framing him there. Could we see a target weak point? There we go. And there we go. By incendiary artillery is going in. Mortar, MG crew burning up. The pack crew as well. Trying to get out at the same time. Explosion into the flamethrower there from the KV-8. Just vicious play right there, just vicious play. So it's really keeping up the pressure here quite nicely. Unless of course you're the Germans, in which case you might disagree on it being nice, obviously. A really nasty situation, But Spanky though is holding on here like a tool soldier of Germany. And going here for the victory point, he knows points are ticking down there, so he needs to do something. Quickly recruiting the pack. Opening up there, firing off the KV-8, forcing that to further fall back. Mortar crew's actually exposed to the shock support there. It's actually pinned to the ground, so they can't actually do anything. Oh, nice rifle grenade there on the mortar crew. Might be able to get it. Can he? No, they pull off a nice escape right there. But a Panzerkampfwagen has been sent forward here to support the Jäger Infanterie Divisionen in its count versus the Soviet find. They're continuing up. KV-8 slowly running forward here, perhaps crisp some grenadiers. Still noting there's been so far no utilization of the commander. Again, there's been no large due to the pressure being laid on upon him by Weve. In that regard, Weve inadvertently actually, you know, neutralizing the commander. And we're seeing a T-34 now moving in to support the KV-8. Panzer 4 almost ready. There we go. Panzer can find fear on to move. Another light barrage here from the field gun. Trying to get the Panzer and the Kanone. Rifle grenade hit the quickly sorting things out in that department. Panzer 4 ranks to support the Grenadiers. Machine guns rattling away. Pack 40 here cleared up by a T-34-76. Contest moving in. And he lost a Grenadier squad. A tragic loss right there for the Reich. MG4J can't moving in. Panzer 4 needs to quickly move in. But it looks like they're trying to deal with the contract. Perhaps to take another serious loss there on Weve. At the same time, pack being cleared out. And now Spanky here realizes he can't really afford to keep around there much longer. Really some vicious, tense fighting going on here. Panzer 4 moving in.
Trying to flank us!
HMT! We have secured the sector.
Oh, he might lose another contract board here. Weve once more might have extended himself just a bit. Just enough here. Oh dear. And he might lose the T-34 as well. This could be where Spanky gets back at Weve with a jackbooted vengeance. KV-8 is still there though, but overall, we've just seen here Weve actually take quite a bashing, and we're seeing an additional T-34 on the way here. I mean, considering he could perhaps consider trying to setting up for the IS-2 instead. Looks like he still feels like something else could win him the war. But again, Spanky very much in the back foot here.
He's
gaining so much ground, particularly going for the victory points. They definitely need those back because he doesn't have a lot of victory points back himself.
You need something?
Grenadiers reporting.
Anti-tank gun has arrived.
Another anti-tank gun arriving here for Spanky. Just rapidly spreading across the map, rapidly trying to regain ground. T-34 continues its mighty advance through the deep snows of Langoskaya. And time for the mid-game analysis. Current situation is definitely rather interesting. I mean, we've seen, you know, Spanky being rather besieged for a large part of the map, match, but still somehow holding out, still inflicting some rather serious losses, and that's currently what's biting Weve in the arse. That is, he rather suffered some rather severe infantry losses, and a bit unfortunate of some of those half-track losses there, because he then kept driving them a bit too close, feeling perhaps a bit too confident, getting a bit too reckless, which can happen, even for the best of us, but in this case, I mean, we are seeing here Spanky playing extremely coldly, and well, confidently, and overall pushing back Weve so far quite nicely. The Panzer IV definitely giving him a bit of a chance to hold on to something, a bit of a rock here in a stormy sea of Soviets. But of course, I mean, he could still risk losing it. Also noting here, this Fugan attack being cleared out, he definitely should recruit that. But for Spanky, I mean, the kind of these bases to pressure out, probably try and see if he can't get some more armor out, and he might consider upgrading me some of those grenadiers with some Jaeger infantry. Additional pioneers might also prove to be a wise idea in terms of damage. I mean, we're seeing here something rather close also in terms of kills, so I mean, overall rather grim fight already. For Weve on the hand, we see he's actually taking some rather heavy losses throughout this fight. He's lost a lot of conscripts, he's down to one shock trooper squad, one conscript squad, one MG of a engineer, and then he's got two mortars, and that department, the mortars might definitely be one of his better chances of getting back in the fight. Rather unfortunately, he has not mined. Again, that's one thing you might imagine again with that sort of territorial advantage he had earlier. I still think you should probably consider setting up some mines here and there to sort of make it harder for Spanky to get back in the fight. Otherwise, one idea now might be to try and save up for the ice tree, although that's going to be rather difficult considering the current situation. Still, it could be one way of basically overpowering Spanky in the end and breaking through all of this. More infantry, though, would definitely be a nice idea, and somehow getting back this field gun would, how should one put it, probably do a lot of good for Weve here in the fight against Spanky and his German troops. Also, he needs to be careful about giving Spanky too much of a breather. I mean, of course, that's partly due to the fact he's just been utterly crippled after keeping up the offensive for so long, and again, perhaps being a bit too reckless in some departments. So, of course, that is going to be a bit the trick. Can he actually pull back after this? I mean, Spanky's now getting more and more intimidating. Again, Spanky's striking back, and he's striking back hard. So, let's return here to the fight.
Blizzard imminent!
Here. Field gun left alone in the snow. Mortars are advanced, sneaking about here, going for the victory point there. Good job, Spanky. Panzerkampfjäger rolling forth. Oh, nice use there, precision strike, wiping out the pioneer squad. Well played there, well played there. Although in general, I mean, German artillerymen, in particular mortar crews, were actually noticed being the more accurate ones, I believe, over Soviet. But then that might just be me and my readings of things. But overall, I mean, the Soviet artillery is always about numbers, not necessarily about great skill. Whereas for the Germans, the problem was always they never quite had enough artillery, and they always had a bit of problem coordinating it. Unless they sort of create a specific command, which generally meant a lot of paperwork and such, it was not organic like, say, it was with the Americans. And that was one of the Americans' great advantages. They actually had a pretty great system for coordinating artillery across numerous units. Mortars are flying out, stealing away the field cannon there. KV-8 moving slowly forward, until we're flying in, and we're noting a second pack. There's just got two packs of the field gun. Now that's definitely going to put a lot of pressure on Vivi's armor. But there we go, mortar crew there wiped out by the Soviet mortars. I mean, he's able to lay down a bit of a murderous barrage here with two mortars, and that's definitely going to make things a bit more tricky here, and I imagine that's why he wanted two mortars. I mean, it's rare to see two mortars. That does mean it's a bad idea, though. But at the same time, though, they're a bit freezing to death. There you go, Panther 4 rolling ahead, straight into T-34 land. mortar getting closer to the Grenadiers. Not good there, not good. 234 to fall back. No gunning there from the KV-8. No switch over to the 45mm gun. And Choxford said versus Grenadiers. So Choxford probably should move up closer to just to finish them off instead of trying to take the point first. Mortar barely makes it away, it seems. Mortar knocks out the field gun pretty rapidly. And about halfway there to an IS-2, the Josef Stalin. Gaviet moving in and burning with those Grenadiers. Not the only flamethrower tank the SOTAP, by the way, did they actually have a T-34 with a flamethrower mounted? I think it was actually in the hull, as the hull machine gun, instead of the main gun being replaced there, interestingly enough. I might be wrong, though. Not 100% sure on that one. Still, I do know they had a T-34 with flamethrowers, which I think they used a bit more than this one.
We are as ready as we can be.
They also managed to make one T-34 there with large mine rollers in front to clear out minefields.
Do you need something?
No recruiting on the field gun gun is marching through to hear the terrible total blizzard. There go Panda 4 laying down quite a nice murder by the rest of the mortar crew. Ooh, mortar round, oh, rifle grenade shot right there versus one of the mortar crews. Did nice work there. Panzer 4 moving in. Weve in a bit of a sticky situation at the moment. Still some time to go there before he can get the IS-2. Still some minutes.
Condition's clear. The blizzard is gone.
Also one thing to note about Panzers using MGs, they were generally a fortified version of the MG-34 with basically a thicker barrel. So sort of avoid the heat. Well, became warped so easily, because the problem was with an MG like that, you can't really shift out the barrel once the fight begins, so it's a bit problematic if that thing burns out. So to avoid that, they basically had sort of a thicker barrel to help mitigate that, and also why they didn't use the MG-42s, that would definitely suffer even more from that.
Yes, comrade. You're done firing on us.
We are losing territory. Anti-tank gun is ready for action.
So little fun fact there about machine guns, and generally, I mean, that was the rule for different tanks. I mean, even the SOS-1, they wouldn't use, you know, regular machine gun, generally something that was a bit more reinforced and was actually, you know, usable in a tank. Again, the whole idea about it's not really much use to have to replace the barrel of the machine gun there, so generally something a bit more of a thicker kind. Second Panzer IV arriving there for Spanky. Weve just burning away there, although rather damaged KV-8 there. Close to losing it.
Our supply sector.
Another attack! Finds up the canoe. Looks like he finally got an upgrade for his Grenadiers. And a field coming straight ahead there. I think maybe he needs to be a bit more cautious here. And there goes fact, he ended up exposing it rather easily to the Panther camp back if you're there. Lots of mortar rounds flying through the air. T-34 rounds to support here, and there we go. Trying to ram. Oh! There we go. Damaging about the same time. One problem. Immobilizer straight in front of his enemy's pack 14. So there's absolutely no chance of that one getting back there. In fact, there's also the Feldkanone over there, as the Germans would have called a field gun.
We are losing supplies to the enemy.
There you go. Almost got the pack 40. But not before the T-34 went down there. Eventually two on the Panzerkampfwagenfeuer. Schützen up. Can they escape with it? Second Panzer forming in. Grenadiers there with the Jäger infantry packages. And noting there, veteran 3 mortar group, veteran 2 field gun turning. Ah, oh, no! Nein! Nicht Helmut! A tragic loss there for the fatherland. They were true heroes of the Reich. Panzer IV driving straight into the base of missing. He's very, very close to an IS-2. I mean, Weve is barely holding on, but he's clearly holding on for just a bit longer, feeling that the Josef Stalin tank can save him and his rifle corps here in the fight.
Watch out!
The enemy is encroaching on our territory.
Machine gun and prisoner firing away.
Machine sector has been cut off.
Panzer IV just driving around. He needs to be careful, he doesn't get hit with an anti-tank grenade, though that would be a bit unfortunate there.
Our command post is under assault.
But Spanky making progress, all those civil weapons left behind there.
Need engineers.
There's enough no sign of an anti-tank grenade. Could he get him? Oh, he doesn't have them upgraded. He doesn't have anti-tank grenades upgraded.
Holy things.
That was definitely a bit of a surprise there. He's been so focused on vehicles, he forgot about that one. Rifle grenades, combination punch grips in a large amount of trouble, and otherwise all he's got left are two mortars, including this one, which is still there. A few more seconds, a few more seconds. Can the ISU bring Soviet salvation? And there we go, blitzing in. Perhaps having sense what's going on here with the lack of anti-tank grenades. Panzer IV continues to circle around and basically drive around hoping to catch someone beneath its treads.
The enemy is attacking.
Looks like Spanky, he didn't recruit the other mortar, he basically just got a new mortar. That was a bit of an odd move, to be honest. But at the same time, he notes Spanky's barely got anything left now. We do see the IS-2 arriving here. Maybe the IS-2 could turn the tide for the motherland. With this 152mm gun. Priority they got for it was basically the high explosive shells. So they could blow up fortified units and the likes. Dealing with tanks was basically the secondary priority when it came to the IS-2, though of course, I mean, it was reasonably effective.
Taking mortar fire!
We go. Oh! Just as a game eventually too, that's a bit peculiar. There you go, IS-2. Actually took a bit of damage there for the Panzer IV. That's actually a bit rare that it ends up taking several shots from a Panzer IV, simply due to the fact its frontal armour has a nice chance of basically blocking the shots from the Panzer IV. I mean, the Panzer IV has less of a 50% chance, perhaps less than 40% of actually penetrating the frontal armour in IS-2, so that was actually a bit interesting. Fresh shock troops are arriving. We're seeing here Weve just marching up, mortar crews leading the way. I'm not sure why he's keeping the IS-2 right here. That seems a bit odd there for Weve. He should pull it back and have him support his troops, I would say. And back to Spanky. Another Panzer IV on the way. The two packs that could prove a bit of a problem for the IS-2, particularly since it's already suffered some damage. Mortar rounds going in, they're killing one from the lead, but the mortar really needs to get out of there. Rifle grenades, MG42, give air 43, and there we go, lost. I'm not sure why he hasn't pulled back the IS-2, but keeping it there. Not entirely sure what he's thinking or hoping to achieve with it right there. That's a bit beyond me. But losing that veteran, if he mortar crew is definitely going to hurt, but at the same time, mean, Weve is plenty hurt at this stage of the fight.
How can we help?
Also, not sure why Park is right next to the victory or the fuel point then. I'm thinking he might be a bit stressed out now all of a sudden, not feeling too on top. And the fourth, I mean, took an IS-2 hit there from the IS-2. I mean, the IS-2 will get it on every shot pretty much. And this pessimist, there we go, another hit, and that Panzer IV is good night. But at the same time, there go the IS-2. I mean, oh, nice hit there from the Pack 40, setting the engine afire. Bad news right there for Weve. Bad news. Shock troops trying to make it through there, but the MG42 rather puts a stop to that. Oh, a destroyed engine. Yet apparently through sheer prayers, the Comrade Stalin is still moving ever so slightly. Oh, Pack 40 and the IS-2 misses. That's good enough. Oh, shot bounces. Oh, the IS-2 got abandoned. Not destroyed, but abandoned. I do believe the Germans actually managed to put one eyes to the capture from the Soviets back into the fight under their command during the war. At least sort of officially they might have gotten a few more there somehow, but you know. That was a bit the problem. The Germans, as the war progressed, you know, weren't really keen on informing the high ups they managed to cause the Soviet army, because they're most likely told then to sort of hand it over. So there were likely some who did not report on that, you know, we captured some tanks there from the Soviets. And instead kept them for own benefit. But a field gun has arrived. Mortar rounds falling down there. Granaten MF up here. And Duska machine gun bunker there, providing a bit of covering fire. That it is suffering for the temerity of being a bit too close. And we're seeing just pioneers rushing through the snow there, trying to get close there to the IS-2.
This is German territory, no! Grenadiers, the Russians are coming!
Shock troops advancing.
Enemy forces are securing our territory.
And there we go, IS-2 has been recruited. Ready to fight for the Fatherland.
We are ready!
Grenadiers need to get out, cut down there by the shock troopers. Unfortunate. Alternating one light artillery barrage is available.
Blizzard conditions are now in effect.
Well, it was available until the blizzard set in. Also note, your pioneers absolutely cannot repair while your vehicle is even remotely moving, so keep that in mind. Keep that in mind. There we go, work on the IS-2 is underway.
We are losing a sector.
How can we help?
Einsatz bereit.
Dina slips first to the
job.
The IS series actually surged later into the Cold War under sort of different guises. Although these Soviets actually themselves ended up dropping the heavy armor concept as well. But they made a few sort of later variants of the IS. Of course, the more familiar one is the IS-3, which was basically an IS-2 with thicker armor. I believe, more or less.
Heavy panzer here.
But otherwise, largely not really different.
Enemy forces are securing our
at
territory.
The same gun and such.
Here.
More panzers arriving. Now this one is in need of some repairs, rather schnell. More field guns arriving. And Weve is still holding on. He knows he's got his opponent down to a few victory points. Of course, he might think there's still a chance here. Now both pioneer squads are, well, most of the pioneer squads are where they're on the ice too. He could consider upgrading him with the Duska if he wanted.
Soviet fire!
And the Volga going off the shot, he was knowing he has nothing to worry about there. And we just think, oh, he's finally getting a maximum surprise. They're getting it something to do with infantry sooner. To be honest, but there we go. IS-2 is now gefecht bereit to fight for Germany. I said, you know, ready to fight. And there we go. On the move, and there we go. Duska machine gun on the way.
Comes the same time every year, and still you manage to lose men.
Taking MG fire!
Field gun caught in a rather awkward position.
Have your spear vision blocks ready?
And there we go, going straight in. And there we go. Weve giving up, having realized the fight has been lost with the appearance of an IS-2 heavy tank. So there you go, a bit of a brutal fight here. We saw Weve really keeping up the pressure there initially, but then falling apart a bit, you know. A bit of reckless action, perhaps getting a bit too confident, losing squads here and there. The two half tanks in particular also hurt. That combined with the lack of mindset, and all of a sudden, you know, he all of a sudden gave, you know, Spanky plenty of breathing space to get back in the fight, and that was things really got dangerous. And that with some lack of engineers sort of quickly repaired tanks. I mean, the mortars were nice, but, you know, ultimately quite not enough without sufficient infantry to really push it forwards. And overall, I mean, that's really what hurt him. Again, you know, the sort of losses without might sort of really drained Spanky as he tried to get back on the field. Spanky, you know, not really able to use much of the doctrine again, though, due to the heavy aggressive play of Davis. I suppose that was one thing towards Weaver, though. Of course, he probably didn't know what command he'd gone for, obviously, until, you know, oh, give air 43s, but then by that it was pretty much too late. Spanky, though, handled this quite nicely. I mean, he held on, though, rather desperately at times, knocking up one half check, basically using only Panzerfaust and rifle grenades. I mean, that's really astoundingly well played right there. And that department basically just holding out long enough, not giving up, and basically bleeding the soap player dry, hoping for him to make a few mistakes, probably. And that's what happened, and that's really what allowed Spanky to get back. The fact that Weve got so aggressive, he made a few critical mistakes, losing a few critical squads, allowing Spanky to slowly but surely claw his way back, combined with some good use of units' abilities, you know, really showcased here, you know. Some nice comeback action there from the Germans. So, hopefully we enjoyed this match. I've learned a few things about this, you know, about not giving up, holding out, and, you know, usage of abilities and the likes. But also, you know, a bit about the dangers of getting a bit too overconfident when you're attacking the opponent's base. This is Imperial Dane saying cheers. Hopefully you enjoyed this. Hopefully I had some fun. If you did, why not subscribe? Tell your friends. Share with everyone. If not, you know, send in a replay. You know, provide some feedback in the comments. This is Imperial Dane saying cheers.